welcome to today's teaching point on bacterial flow cytometry. Now, if we take a look at the arrangement, the size from the atom to the eukaryotic cell, we can see the range from 1 millimeter down to 100 picomillimeters. These are different ways we can observe these objects. Flow cytometry has a standard range from about 0.3 up to over 100 microns, limited predominantly by the nozzle that is being used on the system. Bacteria pose an interesting challenge in flow cytometry as they're at the lower limits of our resolution. So it's very useful to have fluorescent tags to be able to identify these. One of the common assays for bacterial flow is viability. Here is an example using the Thermo Fisher Live Dead Backlight Kit. This uses two dyes, a cell permeant nuclear dye, cyto9, and a cell impermeant dye, propidium iodide. When we plot PI versus cyto9 fluorescence, and this is using Staph aureus, we can identify the live cells from the dead cells. Another thing we can do with this assay is count the bacteria by using a bead. So here we are looking at just green fluorescence in this case. Our dead cells have low green fluorescence, our live cells have high. But now we have a bead, so we can actually calculate the number of live cells in our culture. In addition to looking at nuclear DNA measurements, we can actually look at viability by redox activity. And that's using this redox sensor green. This is a nice compound because it works on both gram-positive, gram-negative bacteria, and it is compatible with formaldehyde fixation. So here we can identify our live cells from our dead cells. How can we use these actually in practical applications? Well, one such case is drug susceptibility. Mycobacterium tuberculosis, for example, there's estimated as about 100 million new cases per year and roughly 3 million deaths. So there is a need for rapid susceptibility testing because M. tuberculosis has a very slow division rate. The use of fluorescein diacetate, because viable bacteria will hydrolyze this to produce fluorescein, demonstrated as a way to rapidly test Mycobacterium tuberculosis in this paper. Here we see the fluorescence intensity of live bacteria versus dead bacteria. And by using this assay, we're able to construct concentration curves to look at the susceptibility of these bacteria to different compounds. And because of the slow division rate, flow can save roughly 3 weeks in susceptibility testing. Another thing that we can do with bacteria is sorting them. We can isolate those for downstream application. Most bacteria we identify using these basic kits, but recently a technique using 16S ribosomal probes was developed, and that is was published just recently by the authors Bonatti et al. Here they were able to develop a methodology to get 16S ribosomal probes into live bacteria without having to permeabilize them. Here they used three different dyes, a viability dye, a metabolic dye, and then of course the probe dye. So our dead cells are shown in red. Our live cells are shown here in this light green. Our positive cells are shown this yellow positive dye. Now, they took this and they applied it to sorting Baltic seawater for alpha proteobacteria. And here are some of the controls that they used to make sure the system was working. Ultimately, this control here, which was labeled with their alpha proteobacteria probe plus propidium iodide, identified these positive cells and sorted them into a 96-well plate. They were able to identify positive sorts based upon turbidity of the culture, whereas the PI positives, none of those showed positivity and other controls, demonstrating that this technique can be applicable to isolating new bacteria based upon their ribosomal sequence. Where this goes is going to be wonderful to follow. So the key takeaways today include the fact that flow cytometry can be applied to bacterial populations, even though they are smaller than our normal limits of detection. Viability and metabolic activity are two common assays. Also, we can count our bacteria without having to culture them on a plate. Flow cytometry can speed up susceptibility testing as demonstrated by the Mycobacterium tuberculosis studies. And of course, bacteria can be sorted by flow. And interestingly, a new technique to sort bacteria based upon RNA identification has been identified and validated. So if you're looking to characterize different populations, this may be a great tool for you to explore.